Hello, I'm Dick Tapper in Washington, where the State of our Union is trying to stay calm. New this morning, South Africa's president says hospitalizations from Omicron are not increasing at an alarming rate as more states across the United States confirm cases of the new Omicron COVID variant, and scientists race to understand how dangerous this variant really is. President Biden is laying out his plan to make it through what could be a difficult winter, including tighter travel rules, free at-home testing, and a major push to get more booster shots into arms. And while the concerns over this new variant dominate the headlines, the Delta variant continues to cause misery across the U.S. Nearly every state saw a steep rise in COVID cases over the past week, and the country is back more than 100,000 cases a day for the first time in 2 months. Let's go straight to Dr. Anthony Fauci, director of the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases and President Biden's chief medical advisor. Dr. Fauci, good to see you. As always, so let's start with the Omicron variant. Coronavirus cases in South Africa quadrupled in just 4 days this week, reportedly spreading twice as quickly as Delta. But the South African president said overnight that hospitalizations from Omicron are not increasing at an alarming rate. So have you seen evidence that hospitalizations or deaths are rising, not just cases? And what does all of this suggest to you about this new variant?
Well, we're in really quite constant communication with our South African colleagues, Jake. They've really been very good about being transparent. They are giving that indication that you just mentioned. Clearly, in South Africa, Omicron has a transmission advantage, because if you look at the number of cases now, they were very much at a low level. Then they had almost a vertical spike upwards, which is almost exclusively Omicron. Thus far, though it's too early to really make any definitive statements about it, thus far it does not look like there's a great degree of severity to it. But we really got to be careful before we make any determinations that it is less severe or really doesn't cause any severe illness comparable to Delta. But thus far, the signals are a bit encouraging regarding the severity. But again, you got to hold judgment until we get more experience. But clearly, it is becoming the dominant variant in South Africa. The question for us here in the United States, now that it is clearly here in at least 15 or more states, mm-hmm. and in about 40 countries, is what is it going to be as it competes with a very dominant variant, Delta, which we have 99.9% of the isolates in the United States are Delta. And it's going to be very interesting to see when you have the Omicron, which is now clearly in our own country, mm-hmm. and there is an indication of community spread. What's going to happen when you have those two competing with each other? It's going to mm-hmm. be very interesting to do what we're doing now, watching it. But as you mentioned, I just heard you make the comment in the introduction, boosters are going to be really critical yeah. in addressing whether or not we're going to be able to handle this.
So let's talk about the vaccine, because you've said the level of vaccine protection might diminish against Omicron. There's likely still at least some protection, you have also said. At what level would you be still satisfied that the vaccines work against Omicron? Anything over 50% or 60% efficacy? What are you looking for?
You know, Jake, you don't want to look for a specific number, but one of the things you do look at, and people ask this question all the time, is that the vaccines that we are distributing now in the United States and throughout the world are directed against the original ancestral or Wuhan strain. And yet, with Delta, when you get a level of antibody and general immune protection high enough, it spills over to protect against other variants. So we're getting quite good protection against Delta when you're vaccinated, and particularly when you get boosted. And that's mm-hmm. the reason why we're saying, even with a new variant like Omicron, if you get boosted, you're going to get your level up way up. And we feel certain that there will be some degree, and maybe a considerable degree, of protection against the Omicron variant if, in fact, it starts to take hold in a dominant way mm-hmm. in this country.
So the U.S. has banned non-citizen travel from 8 African countries, including South Africa, but not from the roughly 36 other countries that have Omicron cases. Yeah. The head of the United Nations slammed bans such as these as, quote, travel apartheid. Given that the U.S. is now imposing strict testing requirements for international travelers, and given that Omicron is here in 15 states, do you think it's time to lift the bans on travel from South African countries?
Yeah. Well, Jake, that ban was done at a time when we were really in the dark. We had no idea what was going on, except that there seemed to have been an explosion of cases of Omicron in South Africa. So when the ban was put on, it was put to give us time to figure out just what is going on. Now, as you mentioned, as we're getting more and more information about cases in our own country and worldwide, we're looking at that very carefully on a daily basis. Hopefully, we'll be able to lift that ban within a quite reasonable period of time. I mean, we all feel very badly about the hardship that that might have put upon not only South Africa, but the other African countries. And for that reason, in real time, literally on a daily basis, we're reevaluating that policy.
Republican Senator Ron Johnson of Wisconsin said this week that you've been using coronavirus to keep Americans in fear and maintain control. Take a listen.
Fauci did the exact same thing with AIDS. He overhyped it. He created all kinds of fear, saying it could affect the entire population when it couldn't. And he's using the exact same playbook for COVID.
Obviously, that's a bizarre and false assertion. President George W. Bush gave you the Presidential Medal of Freedom because of your leadership in the AIDS crisis, but I did want to give you an opportunity to respond.
You know, Jake, how do you respond to something as preposterous as that? Overhyping AIDS? It's killed over 750,000 Americans and 36 million people worldwide. How do you overhype that? Overhyping COVID? It's already killed 780,000 Americans and over 5 million people worldwide. So I don't have any clue of what he's talking about.
I don't think he does either. Dr. Anthony Fauci, thank you so much. Appreciate it.